Hello everyone. In this video, we will learn two important things. One is interface and two is about the connections, the ports, exports and implementation ports. Let's start with the interface. An interface is a block that encapsulates signals. What I mean is similar and related signals are grouped inside one interface, which is then driven by a driver. Let's say there is a system on chip with input and output pins. Interface is a block that can cover related signals into one entity so that it becomes easy to manipulate signals on pin level using driver. For example, these 8 pins here can be for a same function and other can be for different function. Let's say this here can be pins for SPI protocol and this here can be pins for I2C protocol. With the declaration of interface, it becomes easy for the driver to toggle pin level information. The driver can do this by accessing handle for interface. Because of certain rules in system Verilog, the interface should be set in a module, only then it can be available to other components. What I mean is we need to use the set method in the top module to set the virtual interface handle. In the driver and monitor, we need to use the get method to get the handle of virtual interface. We set the interface and in the monitor and driver, we get the interface handle. Let's first create an interface now. We will write interface, name of our interface, which is end interface. It will contain some input 1, input 2 signals, maybe output, depending on the DUT that we are using. This is the code for the interface. Now we need to instantiate this interface in the top module. Let's see how to do that. Here in the top module, we need to instantiate the handle for interface. We will do this by using our interface and we'll give some name. INTF. We just instantiated our interface just like the design. Now we need to use the set method to set the interface in the database. Let's see the syntax for it. In the initial begin block, we write this syntax: UVM config database, then we pass our interface as the parameter, virtual name of our interface. We need to set the interface, so we write set, then we have to write null. Star is for it to be available to all the components. INTF is the handle name that we are giving it throughout the components. This is the set method. Similar is the syntax for get method that we have to write in the driver and monitor. So, in the build phase of driver and monitor, we will get the interface handle. So, we write UVM config database, then we write virtual virtual our interface name, get same syntax. And we also need to instantiate our interface. So we write our interface INTF. Here we instantiated our interface. And this is the get method of interface. Same will be the syntax for monitor. So let's just copy paste this in the build phase of monitor, this, and similarly we also need to instantiate the interface here. So we write our interface INTF. So to understand the syntax more, you will need to read the links that I have mentioned in the description. This syntax is quite difficult to understand, but once you read the materials that I have written in the description, you'll get to understand this syntax. For now, for basic level, we can just remember this as a syntax and proceed with our test bench architecture. So this is how we can set an interface object so that all the components that needs it can get it. Now let's see about the connections, the ports, exports and implementation ports. The second thing we need to learn is about the connections, the ports, exports and implementation ports. Let's take an example of a computer. Just like how the computer needs a connector wire to connect itself with the power source, our components need a connector wire to connect and communicate. The ends of this wire can be port, exporter and implementation port depending on the function. Let's take this example. The ports can be the source of electricity. Exports can be the medium through which we get the electricity to our computer. And implementation port is the part where the application of electricity can be implemented. This should give you a general idea, although this topic is much more complicated, but that does not concern us as of now. In the test bench, we need to make connections between sequencer and driver, monitor and scoreboard. The monitor and driver will be connected to the interface without any ports through virtual method, because those are the rules of object-oriented programming. First, we will have to build these ports and exports into our component, and then we will have to interconnect them. So let's see how to do that. Let's take an example of monitor for now. To build a port, we will write UVM analysis port. Here we have to pass our packet class. Here we have to pass the name of our packet class, and we can give the name of our monitor port, whatever name we want to give. Let's give it mon port for now. And here in packet class, our sequence item's name is our sequence item. We just gave the name to our monitor port, but now we also need to create it. We will create it in the build phase. So in the build phase, we will use the new function. So we write mon port is equal to function new. We need to pass two parameters here. First is the name or string for this monitor port. So we will write monitor port, and secondly we need to pass this here. We can do the same thing for driver and create a port in driver also, but fortunately we won't have to do it because it already has built in the base class of the driver. That is, this UVM driver class already has a port declared in it, even in the sequencer. So we will just connect the existing ports, which we can do it in a class which sits on a higher level, which is the agent class. So this, what I mean to say is, this UVM driver class already has a port. We just need to connect it. So to connect it, we will just go to agent class. Because the sequencer and driver are inside our agent class, we will connect both of them here in the connect phase of agent class. So in the connect phase, we write the name of our driver, the handle name of the driver, which is DRV, dot the name of the port of the driver, name of port of the driver, dot connect. Connect to what? We need to connect it with handle name of sequencer, which is SEQR, dot name of port of the sequencer. But now we also know the name of the port. The name of the port for driver is SEQ item port. That is the name given by the creators of UVM. So we will just follow along. Sequence item port, and for sequencer, the name is sequence item export. So the sequence item port and the sequence item export are the names given in the base class. If we were to create our own ports, we could name it anything, but we will follow along. This is how we can use the build phase to build the ports, and in the connect phase, we will connect the ports. Please refer to the links mentioned in the description for more details. Reach out to me via the comments below if you have any doubts.